There are no two ways about it. A large enough asteroid strike would be bad news for life on Earth. Were a massive rock from space to crash down anywhere on our planet, then we're talking an all-out global catastrophe. But still, what would unfold if the fates truly aligned against us and that same rock happened to land on another major doomsday target? This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, what if an asteroid hit Yellowstone? Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content. Yellowstone National Park surely delivers some of America's most picturesque and breathtaking landscapes. But beneath all that beauty, there's some serious trouble brewing. Much of the park doubles up as the Yellowstone Caldera, the most famous supervolcano on the planet. We took a deep dive into the precise mechanics of Yellowstone in another recent video, so be sure to check that out after this. But for now, here's a brief rundown. Beginning about 5 miles below the surface of the park, there sits a massive 50-mile-wide, 10-mile-deep magma chamber. Burning, toxic, molten material is always churning away here, and the pressure is continually cranking up. One day, that pressure will tell, and Yellowstone will blow. In what could go down as a defining and catastrophic moment in not just the history of humankind, but the history of Earth itself. In recent times, there's been plenty of talk over exactly how concerned we should be. We know of at least 3 major eruptions in Yellowstone's relatively recent history. One that was 2.1 million years ago, another that was 1.3 million years ago, and another that was around 640,000 years ago. Crunch those numbers, and it can be argued that we're due for another eruption any day now. But really, almost all scientific predictions claim that we're actually almost certainly safe, and probably will remain safe for thousands of years more. So there's no need to overly worry just yet. But still, what would happen if the natural course of Yellowstone was ever influenced by an external factor? Even if it doesn't blow of its own accord, might something else trigger the disaster anyway? What would happen if an asteroid landed right on top of it? We're talking about the ultimate in doomsday scenarios here. An asteroid strike and a super eruption all at once. One moment, the Earth's as it is right now. The next, it's changed forever. And there's no doubt that such an event would cause untold destruction. An asteroid the size of what's probably the most famous asteroid in Earth's history, the one that's widely believed to have killed off the dinosaurs, would almost certainly be enough to at least disrupt the Yellowstone caldera into some kind of action. We know that the dramatic physical effects of the Chicxulub impactor, the dinosaur asteroid, can still be traced in the landscapes and formations across the Yucatan Peninsula in Mexico, where it struck around 66 million years ago. It's thought that that rock had been a little over 6 miles wide. But of course, there are many larger asteroids than that out there too, tumbling through space. That event was already enough to trigger widespread extinction. But really then, it still, unbelievably, could have been worse. The asteroid might have been even bigger, and the impact, which it's thought already generated the energy equivalent to many billions worth of atomic bombs, might have been even more devastating. Clearly, with or without a supervolcano, we know that another asteroid of that size could bring about Armageddon all on its own. Equally, with or without an asteroid, a Yellowstone eruption could also trigger the end of days all by itself, creating, as it would, a miles-high plume of toxic volcanic debris and sending a rushing, crushing, deadly fog of ash and rock across all North America. When Yellowstone blows, if it does so to its highest potential, we could be facing a worldwide climate disintegration. Thick, smoky clouds, even as far as Europe and beyond, choking the air and perhaps even blocking out the sun, according to some of the harshest, worst-case scenario predictions. The water cycle is ruined as it becomes saturated with burning ash. Scorching periods of blistering rain further harm the humans that are left, while also destroying the crops that remain, and a global shutdown of power and communication makes mounting a recovery even more difficult. So, all in all, if you happen to be alive on the day that an asteroid strikes Earth and it falls on or close to Yellowstone to cause it to blow, your chances of survival in the short or long term are extremely slim. However, while there's no real-world data to show exactly how this scenario would unfold, one possibility is still that an asteroid might hit Yellowstone and not trigger a separate eruption. When it comes to Earth's deepest geological, tectonic, and volcanic processes, they're notoriously difficult to predict. In the case of Yellowstone, observers have a few key features to watch out for that might indicate a coming eruption, including an increase in local seismic activity and the ground literally rising and falling as if the park itself is breathing. But if an asteroid were to land on top of that, like right on top of it, then the impact itself might just as well cancel out the super eruption. The volcano could well still blow, but it would be as though it had been swallowed up by the also apocalyptic effects of the initial asteroid strike. That is, if the asteroid is big enough, and really any asteroid that brings with it enough power to set off Yellowstone would have to be very, very big. Perhaps the true worst-case scenario here, then, is that an asteroid might strike somewhere else on Earth, but directly provoke Yellowstone into an eruption as well. We know that following previous asteroid events in Earth's history, including the Chicxulub asteroid that ended the dinosaurs, there have been volcanoes blowing their tops all over the world map as a follow-on result. Ultimately, a large asteroid event is one of the only things that can have an instant impact even on the geological integrity and stability of a planet. The force and shock of a piece of rock crashing into a helpless world can be enough to almost vibrate that world into action. So, for pure speculation, we might imagine an asteroid coming down in the middle of the Pacific Ocean or on the North American East Coast, but still releasing enough energy to tip the tectonic scales just enough so as to set Yellowstone into motion, even if it's hundreds of miles away. Then, not only would there be all the expected untold damage and ruin around that fabled volcano in northwest Wyoming, but there'd also be an asteroid impact site elsewhere on Earth to deal with as well. Rather than a single massive but combined problem, it's two end-of-the-world events for the price of one, and human beings would be extremely hard-pressed to foot that bill. In whatever way you look at it, this is one doomsday scenario that any one person would be extremely unlikely to survive. Do you think you could make it out alive? The good news is that, as scientists routinely assure us, neither an asteroid strike nor a Yellowstone eruption is likely to happen any day soon, or indeed, any lifetime soon. And so, the chances of both of them happening at the same moment are incredibly slim. Thankfully, this is a hypothetical rather than a real-world issue. But nevertheless, that's what would happen if an asteroid hit Yellowstone. What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments. Check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.